Hello, welcome to my video about the physics of red dot sights. here's a diagram on the screen, and we're going to come to a few diagrams later at maybe the 6.5 minute mark. I'll put in chapter points in this video. But first, let's have a look at what we see when we've got a static target and a static weapon with a red dot sight mounted on that static weapon. And let's see what happens when we move the camera around as if it was our eyes to see through the sight. The pistol is set up on a box, propped up and pointing down range, and I've got a target down there, and let's zoom in and have a quick peek at the target. There we go. Now if we then come down to the sight, we'll see the green dot, and that's pretty much at the middle bottom of the sight area. You can see the sight outline out of focus, of course, because we're focused on the target. And what we want to do from this point, the optimum point is going to be about there, the optimum point of having the dot in the sight. But of course, the whole point is that it doesn't move too much. But if we go to the edge, we'll see some movement of the dot. So even though the gun is remaining trained exactly where it was, so the gun isn't moving at all and the sight isn't moving, if we go around the edge of the sight, it really, around the centre, it's fairly, around this area here in the middle bottom of the sight, it's fairly stable. So we're at a distance of about 5-6 meters from the sight, so really too close ideally for a sight like this, but it's still more accurate than an iron sight, I would say, which is obviously what the gun has. But once you get to the edge of the lens, the refractor, it starts to go off by a centimeter or two at this distance. It's not great. You're getting a bit of blur on the in fact, it's worse when I look at it actually with my eyes than what you see here. You're seeing a fairly defined dot there, but on mine it's not as pretty at all when I just look at it with my eyes. So who knows what that's about. But that gives us an idea that it maybe goes out by up to a centimetre, and if I go up to the limit at the top, perhaps even 2 centimeters up and down, and a half a centimeter to a centimeter off left to right. So that's what you get there. Let's just look at, zoom in at the sight again so you get an idea of what we're looking at there. And that's a standard, I guess that's a 5-inch square piece of card there. Now we're looking through the red dot sight at a distant object, probably 120 meters away. I'll put the actual distance on the screen now. So we can see just at the base of the chimney stack where it meets the roof, you can see the green dot, and that's probably the optimum sighting position. And if I go across to the edge, you can see there's very little movement, but there is a bit. And if we go up, we start to see that same streaking of the dot as we come off. So if I come up there, as soon as you're more bit about two-thirds of the way up the lens, you're really getting inaccuracy in that kind of spread of the dot. But you can assume it's the bottom of the dot that will be fairly accurate. So yeah, there's less of that, what people are calling parallax effect. More discussion on that, of course. So but of course, when you're using a 0.177 air pistol, this is entirely irrelevant, this long distance, and it's the short distance stuff
15 metres and below, maybe 20 metres and below, that matters. So you'll have seen my demo with the 5 metre, 6 metre distance just now. So I've just put a flat piece of Perspex in front of the red dot sight lens, the curved mirror, and there we can see the green dot up on that roof. And now, without having the advantage of the benefit of the curve, we can see how much it wouldn't work, how much parallax we get with a flat lens. And there we go, it moves quite far across the roof there. So I'm not moving the weapon at all, and I'm not moving the Perspex sheet, I'm just moving the camera from side to side. So that demonstrates the importance of the curvature on the lens, on the mirror, refracting lens, the refracting mirror of the red dot sight. So let's take that away. And yeah, you can see it there, just where the chimney meets. You see it's barely moving now. Okay.
Right, so in this diagram, we see the lens of the red dot sight here. These are representations of where your eye might be behind the sight, and you're looking downrange at the target, which will be way off the top of this screen. So here's the LED of the red dot sight, and the LED's reflection is reflected off, and you see it with your eye. So when you're looking with your eye at the lens of the sight, then you'll see a red dot in the lens, and that's a reflection from the LED. Now, we should all know that light always reflects at the same angle as it comes in on. So if light were to, say, if light were to hit this lens from this angle, it would bounce off there, okay? But if light comes at this angle, it bounces off there. Now, one thing you'll notice about the light as it bounces off, it's always bouncing off in a straight line back to the eye. So the eye will only see the dot if the eye is positioned exactly behind the lens. So if you can imagine your red dot sight on the top of your weapon, you imagine making a cylinder from that and following that cylinder back towards your eyes, towards where you are. You have to get your eye into that cylinder that's directly behind the sight. You can't have your eyes off at a funny angle behind the weapon. You have to, your eye has to be in this cylinder going down through here. It has to be in this area here somewhere. It can be any distance away from the sight, but it needs to be, you can't have your eye off here or your eye off here. It has to be behind the sight. So let's see what we see if we get further away. So I've just zoomed out now, and what we're seeing is where that this red dot, so there aren't two red dots, there's only one red dot. This is representing one eye position, this is representing another eye position, and this is representing another eye position. The light in a straight line to the target just goes straight to the target here, because you're not behind the sight, so you won't see the red dot. Okay, so these eyes, where if you position your eye here or here, behind, directly behind the sight, you'll see the red dot. But you'll see it directly in front of your eye, in the axis of the sight and the axis of the weapon. So the red dot appears to be half a centimetre or a centimetre to the left of the target, or a couple of millimetres to the right of the target, depending on where your eye is. And of course, the further that target is away, the more accurate it is in one sense in terms of the angle to the target. Right, let's think about this more from another perspective. Well, not really a perspective. Imagine the red dot sight, the lens, was flat and not curved. So there's your LED. What if you have your eye positioned here? Well, again, like I said, the light bounces off a surface at the same angle as it arrives at the surface. So this eye here will see the red dot halfway between the position of the eye and the position of the LED, instead of being directly in front of the eye in the axis of the weapon. So the eye sees the red dot there, and if it follows that line, it's going to end up way off target, and the further you go, the more off target it will be. The eye here is fairly central to the axis of the weapon and the sight, but still it's aiming in the wrong direction. Let's move one more, and here I've zoomed out, as it were, the target's further away, and you're going to end up missing the target by huge amounts. So that's why you can't have a flat reflector for your LED. It has to be curved like this, okay, to make sure that it bounces so that it's coming directly backwards. So if you move your eye in a bit, the red dot will move in a bit. And if you have your eye right in the middle, the red dot will be right in the middle. But that's fairly irrelevant. It just means that you're going to be a couple of millimeters more accurate if you've got your eye and the dot right in the middle of the sight. So, moving on back past the what happens if you have a flat lens, where you end up way off target. And here, we've zoomed out on the curved proper red dot sight, and we see, even at a huge distance, they're very close. I mean, this, you can imagine this being a much longer distance, you know, for an air pistol, maybe 15 meters away, and you'll still end up with your dot being a couple of millimeters off the intended target. And if you're 100 meters away, it will still just be a couple of millimeters off the intended target. So this is how a red dot sight works. Now let's look from the side of the gun. So far we've looked top down at the gun, and now we're going to look at the side view. So looking, the target is way over this side of your screen. Your weapon is pointing in that direction over there. Your eye is behind the gun and behind the sight over here. And again, we have the same thing. We need the red dot to appear in the lens at exactly the same height as your eye is positioned behind the lens. If your eye is above the lens, you won't see a red dot at all. You'll just be looking straight at the target. But if your eye is within that cylinder that I was talking about, that comes back from the red dot sight, then you will see the red dot reflected in the lens. So remember what I said about the angle of approach of the light equals the angle of departure of the light. So this curve has to be shaped so that the red dot always appears at exactly the same height as your eye. So the line is pointing exactly horizontally relative to the sight and weapon, horizontally relative to the barrel at the target. And if your eye is down here, the curve, you're hitting a different part of this curve, and the light coming from the LED goes straight to your eye in a horizontal line, and that means that horizontalness is parallel to your barrel. Or you may have some adjustment for elevation, of course, in which case you might have this aiming slightly below the angle of the barrel, but that's another question that I don't want to get into. And then at a distance, there's your target, here's your eyes, well, one eye, you're not going to have both eyes, so your eye could be in this position, and you see the red dot fairly high in the lens, and you end up looking at the target, or fairly low at the lens, fairly low, and you end up looking at the target. And imagine this being a long way away and this being a couple of millimetres. So if it's 100 metres away, you'll see the red dot 2 millimetres below the target or above the target. So this is what the red dot sight does for you. So thank you for watching this. I hope that explains it fairly well. People bandy around the word parallax quite a lot, and I'm not sure why. Parallax is not really much to do with this. I don't understand. They say about, oh, you know, what's the parallax on your red dot sight? Have you eliminated the parallax? Well, the whole point of the sight is to have a line that's parallel to your barrel, either from the side or from the top. And if your eye is 3 millimeters to one side here, it's going to show the red dot 3 millimeters to the left of the target. You've got this, this is effectively focused on infinity. So the further away from the target you are, the less angular, the less out you are in terms of angle, but because you're always going to be just 2 millimeters out, whether you're here or whether you're there or wherever. So I hope that's useful. I found the videos on the internet about this not very helpful, so do comment in the description if you've got anything to say. And do make sure you watch the other two on this review of my cheap eBay red dot sight. There's a playlist, and you'll see that at the end of this video or in the description or in my playlists on my channel. Thank you.